TV, you're at the gym, and I'm pleased to say I've just bumped into Jamie Quinn. How are you doing, Jamie?
Good, mate, yeah.
Good to see you down there sparring, mate.
Yeah, it's good to be back.
You haven't been away, have you?
Hey?
Saying you've been one of the busiest fighters in the country.
I know, got a bit lucky there with medicals and everything. Like, basically, I had my medical done like March, just before all this COVID come in. And I was a bit devilled about it because I didn't think there's going to be no fights for it. I've paid all that money for my medical. And then because they weren't doing medicals at the time, managed to get about six fights that I weren't expecting to get. So, bonus.
He was like one of the journeyman fighters who had
the medical. Oh, no, I bet all the other journeyman was envying me, weren't they?
Being on the road in boxing is, you know, you're one of the main roadmen at the moment in the game. You know, I was speaking to your trainer there, Joe. It's an art, really, getting in there with all these
definitely.
Young fighters and all these big punchers. Fighters who have a lot behind them as well, you know, some of these Olympians and things. You're going in with these and every week it seems sometimes. What is the key to having that skill and surviving with these top fighters?
Like you say, it's an art. You've got to, same with any job, you've got to mix the rough with the smooth. Like, you're going there some days, you'll have an easy day, like, that your opponent will probably be predictable, probably won't be like that fit, won't be that strong. So it can be an easy night, and then other times you've got someone that's got an engine like mad, like he's coming to take your head off with every punch, like, so like that's like the difference. Say you're on a building site, that's the difference between a sunny day and a rainy day, like, or an early dart and a late dart. But I suppose you just got to learn to adapt to it, really. Like, well, how I tend to do it, any advice I'd give for any up and coming journeyman was just always, I think Christian Lake taught Cassius Hussain told it to me, like, and it's true, like, you've got to just always expect to have an hard fight, never expect an easy fight, like, so always going there, ready for the guy to be a big puncher, ready for him to be all over you, and if he's not, then it's just a bonus, like, since it's an easy night, like, but I've made that mistake a few times before. I've looked at a person from a fight from a few years ago, thought it's a walk in the park, like, not really took it serious, come in the first round, thought, oh shit, I'm in trouble here, like. So you just one of the main things is you've got to keep in shape. Like, you've got to be ready. Like, if you're not in shape and you're going to get found out. Like, I know myself, it's a lonely place. You get hurt. Like,
yeah. I mean, you say that you'd think that you're just, you know, going for a walk in the park. You look very calm and you're having a bit of a laugh. You're joking. You're a poker face.
It's all a poker face. Like, yeah. But it gets me a bit of attention. I know a lot of people don't like it, but like. I just, the way I see it, if you can have a bit of fun in what is like one of the cruelest, hardest sports about, like, then you're doing something right.
Do you know when you're in there with someone who you think is just that little bit special and you could get it or potentially knocked out? How do you get your mind around that, and how do you adapt to that? Do you look to buy time? Do you look to tie them up?
Yeah.
Take away their assets? And there's a lot of skill to it, as well as a lot of bravery and a lot of madness.
When they're like that, you've got to do whatever you can just to spoil the style, really, to take it. Like, but obviously you can't let the fighters like get too comfortable with you. They're gonna walk all over you, like, you know, they're gonna take more chances, like, and everything, like, and then obviously because they're eager to impress, like. Personally, like, what I tried to do, tried to get close to him, thing, and then obviously you can't just cover up sometimes. Sometimes you got to let a few shots go, get yourself a bit of respect. But like I say, all depends. Like, you get some people who are dead skillful, like, and they're dead awkward, but like they've not got a lot of power. And you get other people that are powerful, but like you can tell what they're doing. And but you get them boxers that have just got it all, and that's just horrible. Like, that's like a rainy day on the building site.
Give us a couple of names, recent names who you've been in with who have had both.
The last fight against like Muhammad Ali, like, to be fair, he had it all. He was dead busy, dead aggressive, like. But the thing is that I actually come in a lightweight. He's originally a featherweight. So after the day before weighing, like, I'm not going to deny it, I had like two weight divisions on him. Like, so I didn't really find him powerful. But I can imagine for a featherweight, he will be dangerous soon. I forget his name. It was on his debut. Like, that was my first fight back after all this COVID shit. Like, what's he called now? McGibbon, Irish kid. Yeah, it was on his debut. Like, I reckon he's going to be good. In like, I say he had a good punch on him. I think he fought Jordan Nelson in his second fight. We all know about Jordan Nelson. He's always turning everyone over, isn't he? Yeah. Do you know what? It's getting to the point now, I'm not even remembering him.
You've had that many fights.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what, Jay? I remember when you first turned pro, and I think it was your second, not many fights in, you fought Zelfa Barrett a couple of times, and there was a point when you was like going for it, you was there to win, you was, you know, you was, it might have been in a wake on a few times, but to you, you was there to make.
I was a lot more ambitious back then. Like, it was just because I didn't want to go on the road. It's just because I couldn't sell tickets and decided to go on the road. So like, but after that first fight with Zelfa, I had about three fights pull out on me. Like, so,
you're trying to sell tickets,
aren't you? Yeah, no, I was just on the road, like, but I had a few fights matched up, like, but they pulled out after that.
So then fighting yourself at the beginning, I mean, you fought a couple of little lads from that camp as well, Alex. You came to win them fights.
Oh yeah, I always do with the Manchester lads. It's just because of the whole thing, like, to the Manchester lads, I like to like earn my respect a little bit, like.
And you'd fought some of them amateur, hadn't you, Zelfa, as well?
Speaking of Zelfa, I wouldn't like to fight him now.
He's come a
looking,
lot.
Looking dangerous now, isn't he?
Well, there's a few like that you can look at. I went in with him a few years ago. Look at him now. There's a few. Like that.
So it's lifestyles. They live, breathe boxing, don't they? Like, but it's fair. It's shown for them, so fair play to them.
Well, your training regime you're always fighting, so you're fit. You're here now sparring. You travel around the gyms. You know what is a training regime for you?
To be honest, I'm only sparring now because I've had a bit of time out. You know, get rid of a bit of ring bust. But back to when the smaller shows come back, like, seems a long time coming now. Like, but. When they're back and fighting every week, I don't even spar me. And to be honest, like, I'll come in, like, say if I fight on the Saturday, I'll probably have Monday off. Come in Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, like, I have Friday off. But like, if in between, say if I'm fighting 1 week and the week after, then I'll literally just tick over. Like, and that's all you need to do. You don't want to be doing too much heavy training when you're fighting all the time, because like, you're just, especially sparring and all, because it's just unnecessary. Like, obviously sparring's like the next best thing to it. I reckon I've got a couple more weeks down here sparring with Luke and Campbell. Like, I'll be good to go. Like,
there's plenty of years left in Jamie's Devil Child. Are you still called the Devil Child?
I think I'm going to change that, you know. I said that first. Obviously, like, it's not a good nickname for a journeyman, is it? Like, people are thinking about it, like, what's that about? It's an intimidating nickname. But, you know, it's like, I got that nickname from one of the coaches in Colomendy ages ago. I forget his name. So Scouser was like, is this you messing about again, Devil Child? Like, I just kind of liked him when I had a few unlicensed fights. I took that name on then, but yeah, I think I'm changing it. I spoke to Curtis about this. I'm having Curtis's nickname, The Entertainer.
Is that what it is?
Has
it gone to Vault now? I'm just
nicking it. Sorry, Curtis. You're retired now.
Jamie, the Entertainer, quit.
I'll be signing that on this week's form next time, mate. I bet they'll still start calling me Devil Child. I even had it once on the Warrington Frampton undercard. They come out, they went, Jamie Devil Tail Quinn. I thought, fucking Devil Tail. Come in like that.
As far as your career, how long are you going to keep doing this?
At least 200 fights, like. At least 200. I reckon I've got that in me easy, but.
What are you on now?
116, I think. Yeah, got that easy. Yeah. Might even go for the legendary Christian Leitch record. Definitely. Let's say I'm 30 now. I reckon I've got at least another 5 years left in me, but I'll just have to see. Like, at the moment, like, I'm recovering well. I'm still enjoying it as much as I. It might not look like it, you know, with my record and like and everything, but yeah, I'm enjoying myself. I'm enjoying what I'm doing. So when it gets to the point where I'm like, waking up the next day and I'm sore and I'm feeling like I'm not recovering and my heart's really not in it no more, then that's when I'll throw the towel in and like become a coach. Like, I'd say I've started doing my PT stuff now again, started coaching, but I've been training people, like a few kids on the estate, like a few of my mates. But it was actually doing well before all this COVID come along, and then the gym's shut, and then summer ended, and then like just come out. But I'm hoping it's going to pick up by this time summer. Like,
Do you enjoy doing that? Definitely.
Like, I've got a few kids to train on the estate. Like, I love it when I see them coming on. Like, and I've had just at the moment with this lockdown and everything, a lot of people are getting depressed. Like, so I've been doing it for a few mates. Like, just my bit to help out. Like, just a few free PT sessions in the garden. Everything. Everyone says after. Like, I said, do you feel mint for that after? It's like therapy. And like, I just said, well, when everything's back over, make sure you stay loyal to me when I come to charge. Like.
No, it's great to see you, mate.
Yeah, you too, Chris. Always a pleasure, mate.
Always is. You're a top man. Yeah, nice one. Top boxer.
Cheers, Chris. Nice one.
See you soon, Jimmy.